Bam, Mr. Tarrou. In this video, we are going to learn how to find determinants of 2x2 and 3x3 matrices. Then in the next video, we're going to use this new skill in, say, like maybe your Algebra 2 or Pre-Calculus class to help us solve systems of equations with two equations and two unknowns, or especially three equations and three unknowns, a lot more efficiently than what we've learned so far, which has basically just been the Gaussian elimination method, which we know is a long and tedious process for solving systems of equations, whether they're written as equations or an augmented matrix. So a determinant, every square matrix has a number related to it and is called a determinant. The determinant of a 2x2 matrix is called the second order determinant, and the determinant of a matrix, notice there's no augmented line here, it's just a matrix, and we've got the square brackets A, B, C, D, and I have D, E, T written in front of it. Okay, now, if I want to write that without, you know, the abbreviation D, E, T, and write symbols to show that I want to find the determinant, I change those square brackets to a couple of straight brackets. And the determinant of matrix A, B, C, D, the rows and columns, you have the same number, so it's a square matrix, is found by doing AD, so we go diagonally from the top left to the bottom right-hand corner, we multiply AD and subtract it with the opposite, which is go from the upper right-hand corner to the bottom left-hand corner, and that would be minus the product of BC. So it's AD minus BC. Now, that as an example here, we have, what is the determinant? I know it's the determinant, again, because of those straight brackets, of the matrix negative 4, negative 3, 6, 7. Well, following this pattern, we're going to do negative 4 times 7, and then subtract that with the product going in the other direction. So we have negative 3 times 6. Please be aware that I'm using parentheses every time I substitute in a number. You should already be in the habit of doing that, and if not, you should get into it. One reason is right here. We have a subtraction that comes from our equation, the pattern that we're following to find these determinants of these 2x2 matrices, and then we have a negative, another negative coming in from the negative 3 that we're bringing in from the matrix. Without parentheses, maybe you'll get confused with the negative that's there and you're thinking this is already negative, so I'm set. Or maybe just, you know, I don't know, somehow carelessly make a small mistake. So use those parentheses every time you do substitution. So we have negative 4 times 7 is negative 28. And then a negative times a negative is positive. So negative 1, basically, we can't represent a negative 1 there. We just don't have to write it. So negative 1 times negative 3 is positive 3. And then positive 3 times 6 is 18. Positive 18. Okay, so we have a number that's a value that's negative, a value that's positive. So we're going to subtract those numbers and keep the sign of the larger number. 28 minus 18 is 10, and 28 is larger than 18, but it does happen to be negative, so our final answer is negative 10. Okay, and along that answer, I mean, that is the determinant. It gets used in other applications. Alone, it's kind of just a number. Again, we are going to use it for solving systems of equations in the next video. How do you find a determinant, though, if it's a larger matrix, a 3x3 matrix? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to follow the diagonal rule, which says we're going to copy the first two columns of the matrix and sort of just recopy those off to the right of the determinant. We're going to draw a diagonal starting from the upper left-hand corner and multiply the elements along that diagonal, and we're going to then add all of those elements. An expansion, but similar to what we did here, we multiplied along the diagonal going from the upper left-hand corner down to the lower right-hand corner. Okay, then we are going to draw a diagonal starting from the upper right-hand corner, multiplying the elements along the diagonals, and then add. And then we're going to subtract the sum from step 3 with the sum from step 2. So it's saying that we're going to multiply and add all the elements going from upper left to the lower right hand corner, multiply from the upper right and going to the lower left hand corner, adding up the elements, that expansion is because it's a larger matrix, more complicated than what we just did here. But then we're going to subtract step 3 from step 2. That's what we did here. We multiplied down diagonally from upper left to lower right, then we multiply diagonally from the upper right to the lower left, and what was in the middle? Subtraction. Just like we have with the full diagonal rule that we're going to have to use with our 3x3 matrices. So let's see what that looks like as our second and last example of this video. So here's the example of finding the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. We want the determinant of this matrix, we can call it matrix A, or whatever, you know, you'd like. You don't have to name it at all, but your book probably does. 2, 0, 5, 1, negative 3, 0, and 4, 3, negative 1. Okay, we're going to take the first two columns of that matrix and copy it to the right of the original matrix. So we're going to bring this 2, 1, 4 over, and the 0, negative 3, and 3. And then that second step said to, well, let's see here, pick a different color. Here we got yellow, or orange. And we're going to draw diagonals from the top left-hand corner down to the right, and we're going to multiply along all of those diagonals and then add up the three elements that we get because there's three diagonals. So we have, showing all the steps, because we're just learning this, we have 2 times negative 3 times negative 1. We're going to add that with 0 times 0 times 4. And then we're going to add that with 5 times 1 times 3. Okay, so what do we have here? We have negative, we have 2 times negative 3 is negative 6 times 1 is positive 6. We have 0. And then we have the 5 times 3, which is equal to 15, and that's equal to 21, and that is the end of our second step. The first step was writing these two columns here to the right. Then we are going to draw diagonals starting from the upper right-hand corner, going down, and again, every one of those diagonals, we're going to multiply, add up the elements, and get a sum. So we have, starting from the upper right-hand corner, when you add it doesn't really matter what the order is, but following the directions exactly, we have 0 times 1 times negative 1, plus 2 times 0 times 3, plus 5 times negative 3 is negative 15, but I'm not ready to really do that in my head yet, and then times 4. Okay. So we have 0 times, well, who cares, because it's going to be 0. And then this set of multiplications here again have 0, so I don't need to work at that. That's going to be 0 again. And then finally we do have that 5 times negative 3 is negative 15. And negative 15 times 4, well, 15 times 4. 10 times 4 is 40. And 5, because it was 15, 5 times 4 is 20, so 40 and 20 makes 60, and there's one negative in there, so it is going to be negative 60. And then we're going to add up those elements. Now step 4 said, take the sum from step 2. Take the sum that you got from starting in the upper left-hand corner and multiplying and adding and so on. That was our 20. Well, let's start with blue, just trying to use a different color for each of the steps. Take the sum that you have from step number 2 when you multiply it down from the upper left to the lower right-hand corner and subtract that with the sum that you got from multiplying in the other direction where you started with the upper right-hand corner. So our two negatives are going to multiply together. You're following the order of operations. There's no exponent, there's no division on this negative 60, so all we're left doing is taking negative 1 times the negative 60 and getting a positive 60. So those negatives are canceling out, and we have 21 plus 60 is equal to 81. And that is how you find the determinant of a 2x2 matrix and a 3x3 matrix. So that means it's time for you to go do your homework. If, however, you're solving in this section of your textbook, you're also solving systems of equations, and you're learning something called the Cramer's Rule, then you might want to watch my next video, specifically talking about the Cramer's Rule, where we use the determinants very heavily to more efficiently solve systems of equations. So now, I'm Mr. Tarrou. Go do your homework.